This is applied science. It's just a third year science, so it's not a Regents level, and we cover several topics. You know, we do some little bit of physics type of problems, and then for the first half of the year, and then we do robotics for the second half. So we do sometimes have some lecture for a few minutes here and there when we need to, when I need to kind of teach them all one thing at the same time. But for this course specifically, it's really a lot of hands-on and just very problem-oriented. These Lego robotics are, they're not just a toy, even though they have the name Lego, but they are a highly sophisticated technology that's been around for a few years. And the idea is to have kids, young kids, old kids, all developing their 21st century skills, using computers and even putting together building these robots. So there's the construction aspect of it and the computer aspect of it.
You're gonna have to do a lot of trial and error and figuring out how things work in terms of the program and setting your parameters. Drive your robot in the square.
Ooh.
That's all I'm gonna tell you. All right, but if you need help or if you're stuck on something, call me over. I will definitely give you some guidance and direction, but that's your goal.
My goal was with the robots was to just give them a challenge or a problem and kind of have them run the solution on their own through trial and error, through discussion with each other and maybe ask for my help. That way it kind of puts me more in almost like a coaching position when I give a problem for them to work at, then it puts them more against the problem, and then I'll become a coach to help them along rather than the traditional style.
They've spent time already building these robots, and they're all kind of the same right now. Eventually, at some point, they'll be developing their own robots in terms of building different shapes and different sizes to accomplish different tasks. And then there's the programming aspect of it, where they have to decide what they want the robot to do, and then tell the computer what to tell the robot to do. So there's three parts. There's the sensors that the robot uses to sense motion or direction or distance. And then there's the microprocessor that will then process that information that comes in from the sensors. And then the microprocessor will tell the motors or the actuators what to do with that information. The little blocks on the computer represent a specific action, and each block has parameters that can be adjusted in terms of, for these motors, for instance, they can adjust the speed, the direction that it turns, the number of rotations that the motor will turn, and several other different parameters that can be adjusted so that they get the right outcome that they're looking for.
I would like to see them become problem solvers and be able to work together and come up with solutions to issues or problems that they have or that they're up against.